everybody, welcome to Easy and Dreamy Chords, a guitar series for total beginners, but also for pros who are looking for more intuitive inspiration to create beautiful chords. For my course, I mostly use open chords, what means that I almost never mute my strings. All my strings are played open. I'm doing this to create a very airy sound without using any effects. I love adding effects in the end, but in the beginning I want to create dreaminess without having anything but a guitar neck, six strings and my own strumming. It doesn't matter which guitar you're using, you can use an electronic guitar, you can use an acoustic guitar. These chords are made for acoustic guitar actually, but on electronic guitar you have a whammy bar, for example, and it's easier to connect effect pedals in the end if you want that. In shoegaze music, effects are very commonly used. Before we start, let me very quickly explain why I'm doing this. This is not a usual guitar lesson with any scales or something like that. My Easy and Dreamy Guitar Chord series is all about intuitive and autodidact playing. What means you're learning by just trying and making mistakes. This is a space for learning without having anyone watching you. You can just try everything you like. No one will judge you for your playing. And while you are doing this, you get inspired by all the mistakes you make and you find sounds and methods that maybe no one could teach you because there are no rules here in my lessons, if you want so. I just want to share what I did for more than 20 years. I teach myself the guitar without going to any school or something like that because I rather liked playing around with it. And now I want to share it with you because I think everything that you can do on the guitar without having any prior knowledge can already sound beautiful and you can already write songs with it if you want it. So let's start. This video is about the two finger method. It's not a real thing, I made it up, but I'm calling it the two finger method because I'm searching for beautiful chords just using two fingers. Here's no complex guitar pattern involved, it's just trying with two fingers and an open tuning. The tuning that I'm using here is the standard tuning, which means E, A, D, G, B, E. Super standard. We start with the E minor chord, which is one of the basic chords that you will learn when you start guitar. You don't have to know the name, just put your middle finger on the A string in the 2nd fret position and your ring finger on the 3rd string in the 2nd fret position. Just make a hand like Spider-Man before he's shooting out webs and strum you the guitar. There is no rule in strumming, you can just strum in 4 bars, something like this. Or an 8th. You can also pick the guitar. Just try what feels right for you. When I started to play guitar, I just took off my fingers and I changed the position to 1 string position above for each finger, what means now my middle finger is on the E string in the 2nd fret position and my ring finger is on the A string in the 2nd fret position. So we get this chord. If you want to know the chords, there's an app that is called Smart Chord. It's free and you can type in all the chords that you like, choose a tuning, the position of your fingers on the virtual neck, and it tells you how the chords are called. I'm using this app and I show you how every chord is called and how the patterns look in this left corner here. So now we switch the position 1/2 step further to the 3rd fret position and then we have something like this. Sounds really emo, sad and emotional. So now we have 3 chords already. The E minor chord. And these 2 further chords. Now when I go another 1/2 step further, it doesn't sound really good. So I choose the next 1/2 step. And this sounds good to me. The next 1/2 step doesn't sound good, but the full step from there sounds great. And also here a full step sounds okay, maybe not so beautiful, but a 1/2 step in this case has something very magical. You can use the Spider-Man hand, you can use your pointer and your middle finger to do this. Just choose a method that suits you and that feels right for you. At the moment, nothing else matters. Let's say we play the second chord we figured out here, and we play it an octave up. That means here is our octave, the 2 points. A full step further, so we're here. Sometimes an octave up sounds much more beautiful, so also try to experiment with this. If you're playing an acoustic guitar, this could be hard, but on an electronic guitar it sounds really beautiful. Now you have lots of different chords that you can try to experiment with, and yeah, just mix them up a little bit and maybe you find something that you like and you can already start writing songs if you want. The next step is now to figure out if a chord sounds a little different if you switch a finger one half step up or down, or one full step up or down. That means, let's say we start from the E minor chord again. And now I change my ring finger here to one half step down. Sounds a little bit mysterious, but I think if we just take off our ring finger here, and we just hop with the middle finger to the next string above, this is super basic and super easy actually, and some people won't find this interesting in the first moment, but if you listen closely, it sounds really beautiful. You can see you can already create beautiful music with just one finger actually. Just try to take off the ring finger sometimes or switch the position just a tiny bit. So when we do this now in the other positions that we figured out, let's see what happens. Here we are with the middle finger on the first string in the second fret position and with the ring finger on the second string in the second fret position. And now we go a half step further with the ring finger while staying with the middle finger on the position we are already. Our ring finger is still on the A string, but if we put our middle finger now on the A string, one half step before, and we put our ring finger in the third fret position on the E string, we're coming from here, and now we're doing this. Now I'm not trying to think about my finger positions too much. All that I'm focused on is on the patterns that I can create with these 2 strings here, while leaving the other 4 strings open. So, I have here the E string and the A string, and I'm now in the 3rd fret position with both of my fingers. It doesn't matter which one, you can use these, you can use these, you can also use these, whatever you like. And I change the higher note, so the A string, to one half step below to see what happens then. So it would sound like this. Sounds really beautiful to me. I would also be interested in what happens when I choose one full step up on the A string, so like this. It's so easy just to switch between a full note and a half step in one of these positions. Let's say you play this position here now. When I mute everything, I would play a power chord. A very simple power chord. When I leave it open, I play a very complex chord actually. And now I can use this pattern that I have here anywhere and see if it sounds great. You know what I mean? I can also try to invert this pattern. Pointer and ring finger are just switching the strings now. So my ring finger goes to the E string and my pointer goes to the A string. So I have this shape. Before we had a power chord that sounded like this. When when I switch it, it sounds like this. Very beautiful. So let's try another step. Okay, if we go one full step further, sounds a little weird, so let's change the ring finger position to one half step down. I'm using my middle finger here. If my fingers are a full step apart, two notes from each other, it can sound beautiful, but also in some positions when they are just a half step apart. Use your intuition and find out while you're playing over the neck where these positions are. I'm doing it like this. So I hope you understand what I mean. Just try a full step or a half step on these two strings with your fingers. Try to change the finger positions here. Sometimes with your pointer on the A string, sometimes with your pointer on the E string. The same thing goes for the other finger that you're using. This is one technique that you can use to figure out many dreamy chords. Even as a professional, it can change the way of how you create music actually. Another tip that I want to share with you, if you are not so much into, I don't know, learning something from out of a book or so, is to try, choose any chord. I will choose the standard G chord here, which is this. And make a two-finger chord progression out of it. Just take off your ring finger. So now, we are playing a chord that we already played in the tip before. But now we're not trying to change the position on the A string, because we already did that. But now we go with the pointer to the next string, the D string. Also a very beautiful chord here. Let's try the G string in the second fret position. Now in the fourth fret position. Now in the fifth fret position. For this I'm using my pinky. Let's go back. So you see, I'm still playing the G on the E string with my middle finger, but all the other fingers try to find just one position on all the other five strings that sounds beautiful and could give my chord a new interesting twist that sounds not just exactly like the standard G chord here. Okay, let's check out the B string. Not so great, but here in the third fret position. Also in the fifth fret position with the pinky. So, and you guessed it, now also on the E string. So we can do this with any other chord now, if we want so. But I want to stop here to give you just a little inspiration to check it out and to try to find chords on your own without having a look on any book or something. Just use your own creative imagination and try just random patterns on the guitar. I will jam now, use my whammy bar here a little bit to add a little more emotional expression to it, and you can listen what is possible. I want to say goodbye and thanks for watching, and yeah, if you're interested in my other episodes, have a look in the description below. There are also some links to my own music. Thanks for watching, enjoy and have fun creating.